of Toastmasters and guests. I want to start out by asking you a simple question. How many of you actually cooked the meals that you ate today?
Oh, I guess I cheated. Half of it was frozen.
Well, it doesn't surprise me not that everyone did not raise their hand, because according to statistics, 60% of the American diet is comprised of ultra-processed food. And I'm someone that likes to cook for myself, and today I don't only want to persuade you to stop eating ultra-processed foods, but I want to call you to action to DIY, which I'm calling Cook It Yourself. There are two different types of processed foods. There are processed foods, and then there are ultra-processed foods. I have a list of different examples of the two. Processed foods can include peanut butter, it can include bread, pasta, canned or frozen food. So for example, you have peanuts, you will grind them down to make them a smooth butter. But after that, you still have basically peanuts, that's what you're eating. But ultra-processed foods has many different additives to it. They have ingredients you wouldn't typically cook with. They have ingredients you probably never heard of. They have ingredients you probably can't pronounce. And they're all put together to make a product that is either ready to eat or ready to heat. I want to also give you some statistics about the American diet. One is that 57.9% of calories people eat in America come from ultra-processed foods. 29.6% of calories come from minimally processed foods. 9.4% come from ultra-processed foods such as meats and cheeses. 2.9% come from vegetable oil or table salt or other cooking oil. And only less than 1% come from vegetables. That is a terrible statistic that we are eating so many few vegetables as a whole, when vegetables should be the main ingredient on your plate. That's why researchers today are saying that the generation of kids today will be the first generation that will not outlive their parents. And this is part of the reason why, is because they're eating so much junk today. But I want to give you some more information about ultra-processed foods. One is that they include 25% more salt than non-processed foods, 33% more sugar, they're higher in calorie, higher in trans fat, and have less fiber, meaning that they keep you less full and leave you wanting to eat more and more. But I also want to touch on the idea of the sugar that's in these processed foods. Because ultra-processed foods account for 90% of the added sugar that we consume every day. Because everything you buy has sugar included in it. You buy a can of soup, they add sugar. You buy a frozen meal such as pad thai noodles, they add sugar. If you were to make pad thai noodles at home, you probably would not add sugar to it for it to taste better. But adding all this sugar causes many chronic diseases. It causes weight gain, obesity, high cholesterol, high blood pressure, stroke, heart disease, and cancer. So you really have to consider what you're doing to your body and really consider your health. Because I'm sure all you have heard the saying, you are what you eat. And you have to ask yourself, is this who I want to be? Do I want to be obese? Do I want to have high cholesterol? Do I want to risk having heart disease? For myself, I definitely don't want to have any of these issues, and that's why I decided to cook it for myself. I know when people say they don't like to cook, they have many excuses. They'll say, I'm too busy, I don't have the time, I don't like to cook, I don't know how to cook, I love McDonald's too much, so I can't cook it for myself. Personally, I don't believe any excuse is valid. You have to make your health a priority. You can't make your schedule the priority over your health. Personally, I feel as you have too many activities on your schedule, you may need to eliminate one so that you can stay home and cook it for yourself. If you're someone that likes to sleep till noon on the weekend, you may need to decide you need to get up earlier so you can cook it for yourself. For example, this weekend I had a meeting at 9 a.m. So I got up at 6:30, went in the kitchen and cooked two meals before I left for that meeting. That allowed me to have food for myself for a couple of days. I put some in the freezer, so when it came to a day I didn't feel like cooking, I would have food to eat rather than having to go through a Taco Bell drive-thru. As I close, I want to show you some nutritional values of a cheese pizza. One is a slice of pizza at Costco, one is a frozen pizza, one is a homemade pizza. Now the homemade pizza means buying an artisan piece of bread, cutting it in half, putting sauce, and putting cheese on it. So if you're someone who doesn't like to cook, you simply can pull this pizza off. So not knowing how to cook is not always an excuse. And the last one is a cauliflower pizza. That is for someone who's maybe more extreme like me, who really likes to cook and will put in the effort to reduce their calorie intake. But if I make a cauliflower pizza, I can eat six pieces of pizza rather than the one slice at Costco. So in closing, again, I want to urge you to stop eating ultra-processed foods and to try to start cooking for yourself. It may not come overnight, but with time and effort, it can come to you. You need to remember your health is important. You cannot have fun with family and friends if you're always hooking yourself up to machines. You cannot enjoy your life to the fullest if you're in the hospital bed. You cannot go to work every day if you're popping 20 pills a day just to get by. So remember, your health is the number one choice. Make it the priority in your life is to start cooking for yourself. Thank you.
All right, thank you. Thank you. We can take